Our next guest thinks everybody should live a fabulously delicious life and is the creative force behind the Holly Pinafore online magazine. Holly joins me now with how to show us a couple of tricks for making Halloween treats. You look so cute in it, as a cat.
Thank you, as do you.
I thought I should be the witch as you're the cat. So this is great. Now, what are we making today?
Well, we are taking trick-or-treat to the next level.
Okay.
We're going to be doing dirt and worms.
Yum.
It's so fabulously delicious. And my three-year-old nephew can make it so easy.
If he can do it, then we can do it.
I think so.
Okay.
Yeah, so you want me to...
Take a look at... Yeah, let's talk about some of the ingredients. What do you have
All right, we have... This is a package of Oreos crushed up. And if you have a gluten allergy, they do have the gluten-free version of them.
They taste
exactly like regular
All
Oreos.
Right. And so you crush it?
You're going to smash them up.
I'm going to let you do the monster mash here.
There you go.
Okay.
If you have any frustrations,
get them out
done.
Right now.
Okay. No, you got to put a little muscle into it.
All right. We have the Oreos now. What else do we need?
Okay. Now, what we have here, I kind of fast-forwarded a little bit. This is two packages of Devil's Food Instant Pudding.
Okay.
You just follow the instructions. Oh, my ears are getting crummy. Follow the instructions on the box, okay? And then you add one tub of whipped topping, thawed.
Okay.
Okay, so that's your Cool Whip. Okay, and so you mix it all together until it looks like chocolate mousse almost. It's delicious. You could just eat it like this.
Oh, you can smell the chocolate.
I know, right? Mm. So I have these little festive little goblets here. Okay, goblin goblets.
Yeah.
So they're about, I think I paid like $2.50 at the drugstore for.
Okay.
So what you do is you just fill the bottom with a little bit of the crushed cookies.
Which I've already done
to save us
some
time.
Should I add some more? Or are you going to?
You could do whatever you want. See, that's the fun part. You can kind of set it up like, a little candy bar.
Okay.
And have the kids, you know, do it themselves, or the big people. Okay.
All right. So let's go ahead and scoop the chocolate.
And before we continue, for the big people, don't be afraid to add a little bit of whipped cream vodka to this, and you stir it up for some extra trick and treat. Yeah, some extra trick or treat.
I don't think I'll be doing that too much, because my party's for kids, not the adults.
It's the PG party.
Exactly.
All right.
It's the PG party.
That's fine. Okay, so now on top of that, you're going to add a little, if you want to do it, I'll let you do it.
Okay.
Because I know I like to let you do the cooking, right?
You make me do it, because you know I don't enjoy it as much. Okay, and you want me to.
How could you not enjoy this,
okay,
though?
Okay,
all
right.
So good.
How much more, just a lot more,
yeah.
Just really get it in
yeah,
there.
Yeah, get it in there.
Okay.
Okay, so then on the top, you're going to add some more of that and mix it in to make it look like dirt.
Okay.
Yeah, so there you go.
A little more?
That's good. No, that's good, because you want to
okay.
top it with a bunch of candy.
Oh, of course.
Okay.
I forgot about that.
Yeah. So then you're going to
add some of the cookies,
and then mix it in.
Actually, mix it in.
Yeah, you can mix it in if you want to get it all like if you want like a wet
Whoops.
Kind of dirt after the rain type of dirt.
Okay.
That's
so we
good.
Have after the rain.
Perfect.
Now we add the candy.
Going to add the candy. We have.
And what do we have here?
These are sour gummy worms.
Mm.
See,
look at that.
Yeah. If you want to add. Some these are little plastic spiders. You just have to be careful if there's little kids. Make sure they don't try to eat them.
You couldn't find edible
that would
spiders.
Be, sorry, you couldn't find edible spiders.
No, that's good. No, I like that because
How
everything is edible.
Eyeball
that, ooh, the
eyeball.
Absolutely, the kids know that. That's
that is
not
perfect.
Real. So that's scary.
It's perfect. Better than a jack-o'-lantern full of candy.
Trick-or-treat candy. And what do we have over here?
All right, now we're moving on to the drink. We are making a Dracula daiquiri. Mm-hmm. But this is a mocktail.
A virgin?
Yeah.
Daiquiri?
This is a mocktail that's safe for kids, okay?
Okay.
First thing we're going to do is we are going to rim the martini glass. It's best if you throw the martini glass in the freezer for a couple of minutes
okay.
so it's nice and cold, and
All
then
right.
you take it out. Dip it in some water, okay, just so the sugar will stick. This is some red sugar. We're just going to
Very festive.
Of, yeah. You know, just kind of get it on... There. It doesn't have to be perfect, but
okay.
just a little bit.
And what do we have here?
Okay, this is cherry juice. If you can't find cherry juice, cranberry juice will work.
This is
ginger ale. This isn't beer. I know, you probably thought it was, yeah, okay. We're going to pour some ginger ale in here, okay? Chilled. And we want to pour enough because we're not adding alcohol. And if you'd like, you can add some orange juice, some pineapple juice, but I'm just going to add the ginger ale for now.
And then
there's some frozen raspberries.
Where,
so instead of ice cubes, just throw
right
them right
in there.
Yep, throw them right in there.
Okay. And then?
As many or as few as you want.
Mm-hmm. They do look like ice.
Doesn't it look like a bunch of eyeballs?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I like that.
And then for some extra flavor, we're going to squeeze some lime juice in there. Okay.
And is that it? And then put the cherries?
Put some cherries. And then I'm going to throw some limes
while you're doing
in the drink. Well, we have the witch. We have the cat in the kitchen. We don't have the broom, but we do have a hag. Come on over, hag.
I'm sorry to pour this.
Yes.
Hello, the hag dear. Is joining us. And, hag, you brought along some good ingredients.
I heard you were cooking, so I went into my pantry.
Oh,
you know.
Do you have those fingers?
I did. I brought some fingers. They're prepackaged. I'm sorry, dear.
Oh, my goodness.
I couldn't get any fresh.
What can you do with this?
It's all right. Well, we can stick those right in there. Well, in the finished
product. These are fresh. What I have here is fresh.
Could
these are some wonderful intestines.
Fingers? We can marinate those with a little bit of extra virgin olive oil.
This guy was struggling.
And these are intestines?
Yes, dear. These are fresh. What do you think, honey?
I think we should throw those on the grill.
Oh, on the grill.
Okay,
yes,
grill.
Yes.
We got secret barbecue sauce. How's that?
Tasty, tasty.
You like that?
The secret to the Dracula daiquiri is that you throw the teeth in.
Oh.
And you throw a little cherry in, so everybody who's drinking can just, you know, have the teeth in their mouth while they're drinking.
And if you do want to serve this to adults, what can you do?
You can throw some rum in there to make it a real daiquiri.
Mm,
and then maybe
good.
An extra eyeball floating
at
the top.
Beautiful. A perfect drink for the hag.
That is fabulous, dear.
Isn't that just for you?
Oh, it smells fabulous. It's looking at me, though.
It's giving
me a spooky little look.
And if you want the recipe, it'll be on our website. Holly's going to stick around until the end of the show, aren't you?
Of course I am.
Okay, good. All right.